Welcome back to my channel and welcome to another craft day. Well, I'm in quite a mess here today. I'll give you a little peek in a minute. But I'm moving from the previous wreath area that I used to the main part of the shed. And you can see behind me every kind of thing you could think of shed-wise because we're just in the process of switching out. But I wanted to get this Halloween wreath made today that we said we'd be working on, and when we did the bow the other day. And then by Friday, hopefully I'll be able to show you a completed product and a completed room area, and it will move on from there. Now, a couple of reasons why I'm changing this. And right now the lighting, I'm not sure, is that great. Hold on 1 second. So anyway, I tried to put another light on, but I don't have it hooked up correctly yet. So we'll have to work with what we have today. I think it'll be fine when I put you down to the desk, but for me up here, it's a little tough. But you can see how beautiful I am without an extra light. Anyway, so today we're going to work on the Halloween wreath. And I have two meshes. I have one that is a purple check mesh. Let me bring you down to the counter and you can see it easier. Right back. Okay, here we are down at the counter. I have this orange mesh, and this orange mesh is a fabric mesh. And let me give you the number for it. It's item number XB97910-19. XB97910-19. And then the other mesh is this purple and orange plaid. And that's a deco poly mesh. And that is item number RE1330F2. RE1330F2. So I have cut these all at 30 inches, and I have a black frame. This is a 1524 frame, and we're going to make 30-inch ruffles on the frame, alternating. So I have 9 of each. Let's start with the top one, which is the orange. I'm going to just fold it under the tiniest bit, so the edges will be less apt to ravel. And I should have spread this out before I started, but I will do that now. Let me get the rest of these open. And the last one. Now this one has a line up the middle they can follow, which makes it easy. Fabric mesh is soft on the fingers. I'm not sure how well it will hold up outside. I don't usually use it, but it was like, if you want orange, you take what orange you can find. And the orange I could find was a fabric mesh. A couple of reasons I'm moving in here. One, it's just a larger area for me to move in. Secondly, the air conditioner is actually in this room, which I'm sure you can hear going, but it's a necessity. And be able to spread our stuff out. Right now I have just a whole bunch of mesh in a big bin. Ribbons are still in the other room. And I'm not sure I'm going to like this lighting, but we can fix that. I won't know until I see this as I'm editing it. Pretty, huh? With the purple and the orange. I wanted the orange. I have black also, but I wanted to use the orange this time because the other one I made was a lot of black. So we'll have it a little bit different. Oh, I went to the Dollar Tree yesterday. And they must have had a ship come in from China because they had the round wreath forms. So I bought 6 of them. Hopefully that's plenty for me to get started at. That fabric mesh I can see really does tend to ravel. I think next time I might use my wood burner for it. My scissors are in the other room still. One more on the bottom. of these up from both sides now, because we're down at the beginning. Okay, there you go. There's the outside. All right, let's start with the top here. To get these open. Okay. This is probably the last, I think, Halloween week I'll make, because as I mentioned once, I don't put a whole lot of Halloween decorations up. But I will put something out on the door. It's amazing when you put in the top row how it fills in the wreath so much. It really puffs it up nicely. And like I said, these are 30 inches. That allows me to have a little space on either end to roll under so it doesn't ravel quite so badly. Now this one, even though it's a fabric mesh, can go on my front door because it's sheltered from weather. And you know, I'm thinking that if the Dollar Tree got their shipments in, and I tell you, that store had carts and carts and carts full of boxes. So obviously they have received some big shipments. And so I fear if they have received theirs, the other stores should be getting theirs shortly too, like your online craft stores, craft outlet I deal with a lot. So hopefully, that's a good sign. Loving it. It's pretty and bright. And not too spooky at all. And I like these little black ties. I'll leave them right in there. They almost look like spider legs. you go. Look at that. All right, let's see that robot we made the other day. Looks a little worse for wear right now. My goodness, I pulled that wire right out. Okay, we have the bow on here, but we had a casualty. I lost a boot, so I'm just going to glue it on. And in the meantime, while my glue gun is heating up, I'm just going to make a couple of little bows. Go. Let's do one more. I'm just crossing this over, bending this down and pinching it up. We'll just put there you go, and I kind of like that better than the other one. Here we go. There you go. I love it. I'm going to take it up, put it on the door so y'all can see what it looks like. I'll be back in just a minute. There you go. Look at that. That came out great. And it's nice Halloween colors, but not overly black and too gloomy. And the little boots are sticking out there pretty good. I love it. I love it. I hope you could see me making it. It's going to get better down there. I'm just moving in and I'm just in the process. So I hope you enjoyed this. I like the bow. The bow came out good, and the little bows down the bottom look good. I think I'm going to put one more over to the left-hand side. All right, hang in there. I got a couple of parting remarks. So there you go. And you can see it over here on the door. And I think it came out really good. I enjoyed making it. It was a little awkward working around all of the mess that we have going. Oh my goodness, Donna, what did you get yourself into this time? But anyway, that was great, and we utilized the bow just fine. And now I'm going to be back again, which will be Friday for me, and we'll see what we can come up with. Hopefully on Friday I'll give you a little tour of how we have arranged my wreath-making area. And until then, I want you to all have a great day. We are fortunate that none of these storms are impacting a lot of people too terribly. I know the Panhandle took a hit with about 60-mile-an-hour winds, but boy, we've seen a whole lot worse. And hopefully that'll be back to a semblance of normal shortly. But until then, and until the next pretty wave comes off of Africa, we'll just keep on doing our thing. So, oh, and by the way, I just wanted to thank you all for your thoughts about Chelsea. Chelsea bounced back after about 3 days on the antibiotic, and she's her regular mouthy self now, jumping up on the counter and telling me what to do and where to go. So hopefully it stays. The antibiotic worked its magic. So she's still good for another couple of years, I hope. She's 13 years old, Labor Day weekend, so she's getting up in the tooth. And you know, I looked on the chart in the vet's office, and I think it means she's like 68 in human years. So you can see that you slow down a little bit then. But anyway, until Friday, stay safe, stay warm, stay cool, whichever you need. Please take your vaccine. Please take your vaccine. Wear your mask where appropriate. And everybody, play nice now. See you Friday. Love you. Bye-bye.